and good morning to all. Today we have a very special guest with us, Ms. Ananya Birla. She's an Indian singer, songwriter, an entrepreneur, and a mental health advocate. She's also the daughter of Mr. Kumar Mangalam Birla, the chairman of Aditya Birla Group. In 2016, she signed with Universal Music India. Her first five songs created waves by hitting 150 million mark on streaming platforms. Singles like Meant to Be, Living the Life, Hold On, Circles, and Better achieved the platinum status. Ananya is the first Indian artist with the English language singles to go platinum in India. She has released her debut of EP Fingerprint in May 2019 with UMG and Island Records UK. It included The Blackout featuring Vector and World, for which one of the first collaboration between major artists from India and Nigeria. She has performed at some of the Asia's biggest music festivals like Global Citizen and Sunburn, and featuring on major playlists around the world, including Apple's Best 2018. Ananya is the founder of Swatantra Microfin, a company that provides microfinance to women in rural India. She's also the founder for Curocart and co-founder for Empower. Ananya has received many awards for her work and entrepreneurship, including the ET Panache Trendsetters of 2016 Award for Young Business Person, and was listed as one of the GQ's most influential Indians of 2018. We welcome you, Ananya, to this special conversation with Gurudev on the topic Music and Mental Health for Youth. Over to you.
Ananya, how are you?
Hello, Guruji Pranam. Thank you so much for your time.
India is so proud of you.
Thank you so much, Guruji. That's kind.
You're such an inspiration for young people.
Guruji, the signal is...
What is happening? My signal... Yeah. Yeah, it's okay now, right?
It's better now.
It's better.
Thank you so much for your time, Guruji. And thank you so much for this opportunity that you've given me to ask you questions. And I've been thinking a lot as to what are the few questions that I would like to ask, because there was and also just everything that you do for us as humanity. Thank you so much, Guruji.
How is your mom doing? How is mom and
she's
dad?
Very well. They're very well. I think they're watching this live, so they'll be very happy that you asked.
Lovely.
So Guruji, I was just wondering, you know, this entire pandemic that has happened, I'm in LA currently, so then the whole protests happened here as well, and then the cyclone happened in Bombay and all of that, and it just seems like one after the other things are just not going very right. Is there some sort of a spiritual shift that's happening somewhere? What is exactly going on? It just feels like a completely new world with this whole lockdown and then everyone in masks. What is exactly going on in the world currently? I'm not understanding, actually.
Yeah, it's a very, very unprecedented situation, times that we are going through now. I think it's nothing less than a world war. You know, during World War, people used to hide in bunkers. There used to be such a fear. Today, world over, people are... There is some problem with the signal. Signal theek karo bhai. Loose wire hai. Let them fix it 1 minute. overworked. So trying to take a break. They have been working since morning, and then so something has happened. I think now they'll fix it in a minute. We should see the positive aspect also. What is happening? People are getting more time to spend with their families, number one. And then those who are complaining that they don't get time at all to do something that they really like, then now they got enough time. And then the third most important thing is the nature is rejuvenating herself. See how everywhere the air is becoming much purer, water has become much cleaner, and birds have come into Delhi, isn't it? You know, Bangalore has, the weather in Bangalore has never been so good in these months. That's the last 50 years, since I know when I was a child, we never used any fan or AC, but today that weather has returned back, you know. Arey yaar, tum log kya karte bhai?
The ozone layer and all that.
Yeah. Spiritual shift is a continuous process, you know. It keeps happening in some way or other. We can consider this is also one such shift that is happening in the world. People are coming together more, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
Guruji, during this period, you know, I've been having, of course, like you said, that I've gotten the time to really look within myself. I think I've become a stronger person. I'm away from my family, so that has, you know, also taught me to prioritize what's actually important in life. But at the same time, many days I wake up and I still feel very, very frustrated. And how does one deal with this frustration of not knowing what's going to happen tomorrow? There's a little bit more clarity now, but I think about, I would say even till 2 weeks ago, there was absolutely no clarity. You know, borders are shut. I didn't know when or where I could fly to. And I personally don't do well with too much uncertainty. I need answers for some reason. So how do I deal with that frustration, and how do I possibly deal with not knowing ki kal kya hone wala hai, for example?
You know, one thing you keep in mind, that this is not going to be a permanent feature. It's a phase. It's 2 months we have been on lockdown, and see, this may continue for another 2-3 months, see, at maximum 6 months. But these are the time that we really have to have the patience. And there are many things you can do, even sitting at home, you know. You can write. Anyway, you are a writer, you can write many songs. See, when you want to do something creative, you need your own space, right? You want to be by yourself. I think this is the time that we all need to be very creative, and we can come up with things. And another thing that will help us to get out of frustration is come up with a concrete plan. What is that you want to do post-COVID-19, number one? You know, for planning, you need to sit and put your mind in that. And then the other thing that we can do is meditation. If we do meditation at this time, you know, the restlessness and frustration that we have will simply settle down. And that's why I'm conducting meditation every day, and millions around the world is following. And, you know, even doctors, I mean, this frustration is a common thing around the world today. Everywhere, people are frustrated because they cannot go out. Others are frustrated because they have to go out and work, you know.
Yeah, totally. So, Guruji, one thing that's really been helping me, like you said, is I've been writing a lot of new music. And even listening to, you know, music, Hindi, English, Spanish, Greek. The other day I was listening to Russian rap. So music has a lot of oneness, like we all know. It's a universal language. So what is it about music that makes it so peaceful, so calming, that attracts people to it? What does it do to our minds?
Ananya, music is more close to us than even talking. See, a baby first sings. A small baby does not talk any language. It starts singing. First it sings and then only learns language. So you went to bed with music. You woke up with music. So our life is so close to music. And music is nothing but harmony of sound. And the harmony of sound, it strikes a chord in our emotions, in our heart, and in our being. So, and meditation, that's why it's been given so much importance even in the spiritual path. You know, you listen to any form of music, that's okay. But you must sit and listen. You know, often people play the music and they keep talking. They don't keenly listen or participate, right? You know, you also as an artist loves the type of audience who participates in your music, right? If the audience participates in your music, you like it. So this is also very important to see that people know how to listen to music, you know. Birds are chirping. If you simply listen to the nature, there is music in the nature. And after music, when you have sung or when you have heard a music, sitting few minutes in the stillness, in the quietness, is very, very valuable. This is something people don't do. They sing or they listen to music and they immediately start doing something. I would recommend people to just sit quiet, just for 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. And let the music settle your mind deep inside. Then you will feel our mind is so big and so vast. Often people think that mind is inside the body. But you know what? Our body is inside the mind. Our mind is much bigger. Yeah? That's why when you are happy, what is the sensation associated with it? You feel a sense of expansion, right? When you get an award, when you are praised, what happens to you? You feel like something is expanding inside of you, right? And when someone gives a negative remark, throws a derogatory remark, what is the feeling associated with that? We feel something shrinking, right? Something shrinking. What is this something in us that expands and that shrinks? This is worth observing. Same happens in music. In music, different tunes can invoke different emotions in us. And all these different emotions enriches life in some way or other. They are also, it's also sort of catharsis, you know. Music can be a sense of catharsis. It can create a sense of joy and expansion. It can also be an outlet for pent up emotions. Abhi ye sad music vagera hota hai na, to dukhi wala ka jo gana, log usko bhi pasand karte hai, taki it's a venting, you know, it's a sort of venting that thing out.
Yeah. So ye jo aap bol rahe the, that this energy, is it energy that is expanding and coming closing? Is it our energy?
Yes, that is your consciousness. That's something which expands, which contracts your mind.
Right.
You know? और ये बहुत ज्यादा, जब ये माइंड बहुत ज्यादा श्रिंक हो जाता है तब देन पीपल गेट दिस सुइसाइडल टेंडेंसीज, देन द माइंड श्रिंक्स टू मच. नाउ डीप ब्रीदिंग, सम प्राणायामा एंड म्यूजिक विल ऑल हेल्प अस टू गेट दिस माइंड इन एन एक्सपैंडेड स्टेट.
How can music and meditation take someone out of a depressive phase?
Yes, music creates the rhythm. Meditation removes the negativity. So both helps in in having a sane mental state. So
if I wake up having a very sad day or low day, I'm not feeling like doing much. I'm not feeling motivated enough. I just want to be in bed. What can I do at that time to help myself? Will meditation help me? Will
definitely
time help me?
Definitely. Definitely meditation will help you. Definitely. Do some stretches, do some deep breathing exercise. Few times deep breathing can bring up lot of prana into our system. Then sit with eyes closed and meditate. Today there is lot of loneliness. People feel very, very lonely around the world. Do you know that in UK they have started a ministry in the government, a loneliness ministry?
Oh, really? No, I didn't know
this. Yeah, 18% of UK's population feels lonely. So wow. There is a ministry like health ministry, loneliness ministry. So
wow.
This loneliness, which really eats people up, can really be overcome through meditation.
Wow. There are times when I feel like I feel an emotion. Let's say I feel angry or let's say anger, for example, or helplessness, say, in the situation. But I know that I can't do anything to change the situation anyway. So how do I help myself to not feel helpless or not feel angry? Because I know that I don't have any control over the situation anyways. I'm doing the best I can. I'm helping myself. I am trying my best to help the world around me. But after a point, it's not in my hands. So how do I surrender myself peacefully? How do I work through that?
Here, Ananya, faith will help. There is a bigger power. Your higher self, the consciousness is there and it loves you, and you put your prayers to that. Prayer definitely will say, I cannot anymore handle this. I am helpless. Please help me. That genuine prayer from our heart, you will see, will bring miracles in your life.
Okay.
Prayer can only happen when we feel utterly helpless or when we feel very thankful. These are the only two conditions when you can genuinely ask or pray. So when we are helpless, we are not alone. See, our lifespan on this planet, 80, 90 years, whatever it is very small. But the planet is being run by an intelligent force. There is a higher power.
Absolutely.
That divine is taking care of this diversity, this diverse universe. And it cares for you too. Here only, you will know that you are not alone. You are not alone. And when we feel helpless, we just sit and quietly pray. And see, music, prayer, meditation, they are all complementary. They lead one to other, one into another.
Guruji, my next couple of questions are a little bit away from our topic. They're just from my heart. The first one was the concept of attachment. So while growing up, I've always, from what I've understood, materialistic attachments doesn't help anyone. So it's all about finding it from within. So how do I know if, I feel like I'm walking on eggshells when it comes to attachment. Is it good to be attached? Is it not good to be attached? I feel like if I'm not being attached, then I am deliberately closing my heart off if I'm being too attached, then I feel like I'm not becoming possessive and protective about something or someone. So when the concept of attachment comes in, how does it, how what's the best way to look at it?
See, why you don't want attachment? Because you fear that it will give you pain. The only reason we want to get out of the attachment is fear of being hurt, getting pain out of that. Right? If you understand this fact, and in any relationship, in anything, you are there to give. You are to. You are here to bring happiness to others. And you don't mind what their reactions are. How they look at you, how they treat you, is immaterial to you. If you come from this space, you know, then nothing can hurt you. The hurt can come only when you have expectation from others.
Yeah.
And if they are good to you, anyway, if they are good people, and if they have clarity in their mind, they are not going to hurt you. And if someone hurts you, it is either they are stressed or they are ignorant. In either case, they need to be forgiven. So when we keep this thing in our mind, so even if, see, attachment doesn't come to you after taking your permission. It is simply there. That's it. Right? So you see your own life from a bigger perspective. Okay, what is that you want to do in the next 30 years, 40 years? How you would like to lead yourself, you know? And what is it you want to give and convey? You put your focus on that. And then not to be bothered about others' reaction, because everyone's reaction will be different at different time. Right?
And it won't speak anyways, no matter what. I mean, I keep saying things, you know. So, that was very helpful, Guruji. Thank you. That was very, very helpful. One more thing I've noticed is that people get very attracted to negativity very easily. So if there's something on TV or social media now, even though we may say it's really stressing us out, if it's a gossip column, for example, it'll easily attract the mind. So why does and what I have personally noticed is that positivity is actually what we as humans thrive on, but it takes longer for some reason. Is something that I've noticed. Why do we get so attached or so fascinated by negativity? Why does our mind attack, link itself to negativity so fast?
You know what? This is my question. I keep asking this question to everybody. You can't ask me my question to myself. You know, if you are given 10 compliments and one insult, what would you hold on to?
I will probably hold on to the insult.
See, this is the nature of mind. But as a baby, you didn't do that. As a small child, you did not hold on to that. Have you noticed? You know, babies, they cry, the tears are still on their cheek, they start smiling. But for an adult, if someone cries and for them to smile back, it takes maybe months. Or maybe weeks or days or months to get the smile back. So the baby lives in the present moment. Every moment children live totally, 100%.
I think that's what music does for me. I think that's what meditation is also, right, Guruji? That's to stay in the present moment.
Correct.
And to enjoy what we have right now in this one particular moment.
Correct. See, negative tendencies motivate people to do more. That's why you will see negative people are much more active, whether it's in social media or on the streets. People, they want to some demonstration, anything they want to do, they are out there. Positive, as you said, now the people with positive mindset, a little laid back and comfortable and say, okay, sab chalta hai. That attitude hai. What is needed today in society, like young people like you, should promote positivity in activism. Youngsters should come out and say, okay, let's do something positive. Care for environment, like you're doing for the women, you know, what is that self-help groups, things like that, you know, and planting trees, caring for environment. That positive activism is needed. I think the younger generation now will take up that, I'm sure.
I would try my level best, Guruji, to always continue with that. Another thing is this whole work-life balance thing. I think, personally for me, what I've always, I think I'm very bad at balance. So I'm a very extreme person. So for example, either I will be very, very productive, or I will just be in bed and I won't do anything at all. Or I will have 5-6 lava cakes one night, or I will be on a very, very healthy diet. So I'm a very extreme person. So balance doesn't come to me like naturally. So why does that happen to me and what can I do about it?
Never mind. Look, it is okay. You are an intense person. Anything you do, you put your 100%, you do it intense. And that intensity sometimes have to take the other swing also. You have to be, you have to take big breaks also. So never mind. You are fine the way you are. Don't label yourself. Okay? Don't label. You are quite balanced. If you go to both extremes, that means you are really balanced.
Thank you, Guruji. Yeah, that's the first time. Thank you so much. That's very kind. One more struggle with is, I know that I am supposed to enjoy the journey because there is no finish line. So it's all about enjoying the journey and maybe milestones and not the finish line. So to enjoy right now, because right now is all we have.
How
do I not focus on the destination so much?
I tell you, Ananya, you are a perfectionist. You want things so perfect. And when it goes little delay, when things don't go in the way you want, so perfect, you get rattled, right? You get jittery, you get upset. No, I would tell you here one thing that would help you. That is, leave a little room for imperfection also. In your work, life, everywhere, don't insist on too much of perfection. A little bit of imperfection is okay. Do you see what I'm saying? So when you accept that little bit of imperfection is okay in others or in myself, then, then we become much more calmer and much more focused. That will help us a great deal.
The funny thing is I don't even know what perfection is. So I think it's my idea of how I want something to be. And I think I have to let go of that sometimes, like you're saying, Guruji, because it drives me insane.
Yeah, give little room for imperfection as well. You can do it, you do it, yeah.
And this whole journey thing of how do I enjoy the journey more and try not forget about the destination, but not focus all my energy on the destination. How do I enjoy the journey more of what I'm, of my life, of my dreams, of relationships? How do I enjoy that more?
It's like music. See, your life is also a song. Life is like a music. You know, in the song or in dance, there is no one peak point that you need to listen or enjoy.
Wow. Yeah.
That's a song. Is enjoyed from the beginning to end, right? So like in a game, cricket, you don't wait for the end of the cricket to enjoy. Or nobody says, okay, I'll come at the end of the game, last minute I'll come and see. That is of no fun. You, every step, every moment of a dance is enjoyable. Every note in the music is enjoyable, right? So the same way, life is also like that, today, tomorrow.
That was a great moment for me, Guruji. Thank you so much. I've never heard of something like that. That's amazing. The way you said it is so simple yet so profound. That really opened my eyes, that life is like a song in that context. So thank you. At the end of the day, when our bodies leave our consciousness, What has been the purpose of this life?
Why should there be a purpose, tell me? Why should there be a purpose for everything?
I think I'm not okay with, how do I accept that, we're just here for what?
No, why should there be purpose? Why should not be there?
Then why are we here then in the first place?
No, why should we not be here?
Why should we?
See, if fun, you're having fun. What is the purpose of having fun?
Yeah.
Fun itself is a purpose. Right?
Okay.
So, life is here to celebrate. Your life is a celebration. So why you want to look for purpose in everything? There is no destination. Don't look for a destination. Just enjoy every moment. Every moment you live on this earth is a celebration. And all that you could do is you can be happy and you can exuberate happiness around you. Anyone who comes close to you, they feel happy and they go. And that gives you even more happy, right? Makes you more happy. Okay.
This is so funny that you mentioned this, Guruji, because the other day itself I was getting worked up about something really silly. So I messaged my friend saying, from now on, I am only going to do everything for fun in caps lock. And that lasted for 2-3 days. And I was really happy. But then after that, I fell back into this whole thing of, oh, what's the next thing? I have to do this, I have to do this, I have to do that. I'm not being productive enough, being too harsh on myself. So I think I'm going to go back into, you reminded me to go back into the, actually, about having fun and celebrating,
taking it from there. Have fun in everything, and even any adverse situation that happens, you should treat it as a fun. You see, if you see your whole life as a movie will be very bland, and it will be very. I mean, nobody enjoys a movie which has no ups and downs, no incidences, right? So, like that. In our life, there are many incidences, pleasant, unpleasant, and all type of the people we interact with. We just take everything like as part of the fun.
Guruji, is there anything like complete altruism?
Complete?
Because altruism, like full, complete selflessness. So, for example, let's say. For COVID-19, if I donated something, of course there was a part of me that was happy that I could do something. So it was not 100% selfless. There was surely a little bit of selfishness in it. And I'm the first one to admit that. So I'm just wondering, is there something like total altruism, total selflessness? And if there isn't, how can I reach that place?
Now, you have had those moments in your life. Suppose you have seen a beautiful movie, very nice movie. What do you do? What did you do? You took your phone and you spoke to your friends and you called them and say, hey, this movie is so nice, so wonderful. You know, you must see that. Did you gain anything by that? Isn't it total altruism?
Yes, that actually.
See, when you're very happy, the nature of such happiness is to share with everybody. You share.
There could be to ask them to come and watch it. Yeah, but that is.
You don't get anything. You don't gain anything. You are sharing to others. You are telling others. You also watch. The nature of joy or happiness is to share. And when you are really happy, when you are content, you don't want anything for yourself. All that you do is for everybody else to be happy.
How does one reach that stage of contentment? Would you suggest it through meditation?
Meditation and contentment in life. The more and more you feel content in life. And then, that simply runs through you. Actually, even now it is there in everybody. In some acts or other, it is there. It it overtakes everything else when there is total contentment in life. And that is enlightenment. When you are enlightened, when you are connected with the universal spirit, when you feel that there is no two things, then it is natural to you.
How does one continue to reach that place of contentment? How does one continue to feel even more content as time passes by?
Well, time will bring that to you.
Is it like a perspective change? Is it about being positive? Is it about following your dreams? Is it about karma yoga, bhakti yoga? What is it about reading something? Is it, or is it just life teaches you as well?
No, life teaches you. Life teaches you. Of course, meditation and these practices will help, but it's life brings that to you.
So it's journey again.
Correct.
As someone part of the youth who sings and whose music is out there, I write all my music from my heart, and it's all my how I feel in my experiences. How do I stay true to myself as a musician and an artist, yet keep the music positive in a sense? So should I sing for myself or should I sing for people who are listening?
Why shouldn't you sing for others? You must. You have been gifted a voice. You have been gifted talents to write songs, music. It's all for the benefit of others. You must make use of that.
Meant in terms of like lyrics, when I'm singing a song, should I sing it because I have felt it in my life, or should I sing something or write a song because I feel like other people may relate with it?
Listen, you want to sing song for yourself, that you can sing in your drawing room also. But when you are singing for others, it is to bring happiness and harmony in everybody else. So whatever is the need at that time, you should sing. Go ahead with that.
Right.
You know, we don't have to feel, I had to sing only for myself, not for others. Don't need to feel guilty or anything about that. We must do it. Anything you do, you know, you do 100%. Do it 100% and then wash your hands off. And then we feel free about it. Yeah, done.
Thank you, Guruji. Absolutely. So people who are out there right now, who maybe, so I had asked on my Instagram just some questions to the fans and audiences, to you, on my page. A couple, because it was, of course, we're talking about music and mental health, I think one common theme that came out through these questions, because that was a topic, and that's a topic, was people who are suffering from depression, anxiety, panic attacks, and various other mental health problems, what can they do in their lives on a daily basis to feel better? And how strong can a tool like meditation be to help them?
You know, there is a mantra to get depressed. Do you want to know?
100%.
The mantra to get depressed, just sit and think, what about me? What about me? What about me? People will get depressed. So I tell them, get up and look at those who are in need of you. You are in, there are people who are in much more dire situations, and see if you can do something to them, help them. If nothing, just make a phone call, talk to them, give them some positive ideas, positive thoughts. That itself will do, number one. Second, pranayama and meditation you must do. You can throw away all those prozac and all those medicines out. Just do kriya, pranayama, meditation. This will keep you with bubbling enthusiasm and happiness. That is why I put together this workshop called Happiness Workshop, which help people 4 days, 2 hours each day. It's online. People learn all those different techniques which helps them to keep themselves in an uplifted mood. Yeah. So not to worry, sitting and worrying, what about me, will take always them down more. Yeah.
Is there's love. So personally, if for me, what I have experienced is the two strongest emotions within me at any given time are possibly love and then fear. And decisions can either come from a place of love or from fear. So how do I identify where that thought or that emotion is coming from? Whether it's coming from a place of love or whether it's coming from a place of fear?
You know, on this, I made a whole exercise for this, a knowledge about this, that it's one life energy which manifests in all these different emotions. They are connected to our chakras. Our heart chakra is connected to love, fear, and hatred. Like our throat chakra is connected with gratitude and grief. Our this navel chakra, you know, the Manipura chakra is connected to joy, generosity, greed, and jealousy. So all these different positive and negative emotions are play and display of one energy, one consciousness in us. But I think we are running out of time. Some other time I will talk more on this now. Yeah?
Okay, thank you so much.
Wonderful, Ananya. We can do meditation. Yeah.
Okay. The language.